All right, hello again, YouTube. So guess who turns 18 today? Da 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 da. It's the Nintendo 64. Supposedly released in North America on September 30th, 1996. Wow. So this little guy is 18 years old. That's crazy. I think that's just nuts. Because I remember the first time I saw this thing in the stores, I had just got the Sega Saturn at the time, and I was enjoying that. And then I got all pissed off because, I mean, Sega Saturn was 3D. Like, it was 3D. Like, I mean, there was how do I explain this? We had like Daytona USA. I remember those games, and Virtual Fighter and a bunch of other games. And at the time, I was like so taken back by like the fact that there was 3D. This, I think, I don't know when PS1 came into the fray, but that was what I knew at the time. And it was only when I finally saw, one day I walked into this computer slash game shop, and it was in a mall, and I walked in, I saw this thing, and it had Mario 64 going, the first game I ever got with the system. I think it actually came with the system, if I'm not mistaken. But this guy, the intro screen has this face, this kind of like face of Mario, and it's kind of like, really, I don't know about copyright. I don't know if I can put that up, but it has his face, and you can like interact with his face. You grab his nose and stuff like that. You can stretch it and stuff. And it was 3D. It looked like very clean. It looked so clean and so fluid and so I don't know. It just seemed like maybe the Saturn had a little bit of difficulty. Or it wasn't as high res, I guess. I don't know what I'm trying to say with regard to the 3D. Like, it just looked much better. This was like kind of, it felt like a step up from the Saturn. I felt like, wow, I'm dealing with some inferior crap here when Nintendo came in with the 64. So, happy birthday, little Nintendo 64. I've had a lot of fun with this thing over the years. I mean, I used to rent games from the shop when you could do that way back in the day. I played, I have a huge collection of this now. Fortunately, I only have one controller, and it's not that bad with the wobbly wobble here. Because I tried to fix that, clean up the controller back when I got this. I think some of you might have remembered I did a teardown video, and went ahead and fixed this guy up here. Awesome console, highly recommend if you can find it. All around fantastic. Of course, not every game was good for the system. I mean, of course, if I was recommending things, I would get, Nintendo's Mario 64, and I would get GoldenEye, Perfect Dark, if you can find them for a reasonable price. There's a whole bunch of good games you got to sort of explore, but there's a lot of duds too, so you got to watch out for that. I do remember beating, Mario 64. Hell of a long game to beat. It took me quite a few months to just sort of find the time to play it and, get all the stars. I think it was like 120 stars or something like that. And then you go up on the castle and you find Yoshi or whatever, and he gives you all these lives or some crap. Yeah, so not a super long video, but certainly I just saw this post on Reddit here about the 64 turning 18. I figured I would bust mine out and sort of, Nintendo 64 turns 18 this week. Wow. Which means you can now legally blow the cartridges. Well, I don't remember blowing any cartridges. These ones worked pretty much right out. You just pop them in, bang. Well, you don't bang on it because, why would you do that? But, and yeah, well, if this thing had its power adapter in it, which it doesn't because it's sitting in the closet. This one has the expansion pack, which is cool. If you can find them with that, that's a nice little bonus. But yeah, here I am trying to make a short video and fucking yammering on and on and on. But really crazy that I was turning 18 years old. For God's sake, that was like not that long ago, but apparently, it's 18 years ago. That's scary. I was a teenager at the time. So that was like half a lifetime ago. That's really kind of eye-opening. But still a really wicked console. I would highly recommend you pick it up if you can find it. They're usually available pretty cheap because people don't like the old shit. I mean, some people do and some people don't. Everybody's, stuck on the new crap. I mean, it's just, I don't care. PS4 and Xbox One, throw them in the garbage. Who cares about those systems? I'm gonna get a lot of hate mail now. But yeah, awesome system, highly recommended. No load times, you know, no fucking system updates to worry about. You pop that in like that, boom, and play some that. Oh, by the way, there's one game I would stay away from, which is the infamous Superman 64, which was a tremendous piece of shit. I don't know that I would bother to... Could you imagine you paid retail for that fucking game? Oh my god. I feel so bad. I mean, that game was like $60 at the time it was released. Could you imagine you paid full retail for fucking Superman 64 to fly through some rings? Oh, you poor sons of bitches. Oh my god. Anyway, I'm gonna shut the fuck up now and just sort of wish my lovely little console here good Nintendo 64. And if you haven't seen it, I'm gonna post it as a link in my description box. Please watch the kid getting his Nintendo 64. It's really awesome. It's got like 20 million views. I absolutely love this video of this kid. I've seen it like a million times, and it never, you know, it's not, you know, it never stops getting funny. I laughed my ass off the first time I saw it. 20 million views. I'm not gonna sort of film it because, you know, it's, I don't know, copyright or whatever. I'm gonna link it, so go watch it. It's fucking hilarious. I love it. So funny. I wasn't that excited when I got my Nintendo 64, but it was certainly a special time when I got it. So yeah, highly recommend. Please get yourself a Nintendo 64 and play it. Wish it a happy birthday. That's it. Thanks for watching. Yeah, bye.